Hi Libra, welcome to your October 2018 reading. This is going to be for Libra Sun, Moon and Rising. So guys, welcome to Meraki the Tribe, and my name is Ayushi for those of you who do not know that yet. Let's see what are the messages coming in for the sign of Libra. And guys, happy birthday for those of you who are celebrating in September, because I'm recording this in September, and also those who are born in October. So let's see what is coming up for Libra Sun, Moon, Rising for October 2018. What are the general messages for Libra Sun, Moon, Rising? Libra Sun, Moon and Rising. Some of you are leaving a situation which was not serving you emotionally, fulfilling you, and then you are leaving the situation because you're feeling very heartbroken and your emotions are feeling like, you know, you feel deprived, like somebody is not reciprocating and they have either left you for someone like somebody else, or you are now thinking about leaving this person because all your emotions has gone to waste. And it's very painful for you because you thought that this person was your soulmate, but you both these cards represent that your soulmate is just around the corner. If you just leave this particular situation and look away, you will find somebody worth it, like, you know, somebody worth your time and emotions. Probably the place that you are stuck right now is not the place you have you should have been in the first place. This is the death card, which is the Scorpio card, and it is the card of transformation. So some of you are probably going through transformation in your life, because it's a major arcana. So it might feel like death, like, you know, you might feel like something inside of you is dying. So that's a very intense message for starting. You might be thinking about a earth sign, also Aquarius. I'm also getting Libra. I'm also getting Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. So you are now thinking about, was this even worth it? The amount of investment that I have made in this relationship, was it even worth it? And you are looking at your work and your investment and your energy that you have put in this, and you're thinking very deeply, and you're just inside your head, and you're like, where did I go wrong? Should I have been focused on something else? And some of you are probably even thinking, was I consistent? Was I giving my best? Or was this person consistent? Was this person giving their best? Or was this all, like, you know, is it like, this is it? Like, you are asking, this is it? Like, this is much, like, this is how much you can invest in this? Like, you're asking somebody probably, this is it? Like, this is what you could do. That is what you're asking. Messages for Libra Sun, Moon, Rising for October 2018. What are the messages coming in for Libra Sun, Moon, Rising for October 2018? Spirits, guides and angels, what are the messages coming in for Libra Sun, Moon, Rising for October 2018? Let's begin. 10 card Celtic cross messages for Libra Sun, Moon, Rising October 2018. Okay, like I said, some of you are dealing with an earth sign, Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. Somebody who is working behind the scene, very diligent, dedicated. This can be you as well. Someone who is trying to stand up on their own two feet. Someone who is making a lot of effort to get up and start moving ahead. Somebody who is struggling to get some stability. Somebody who is relying on themselves for stability and security. Somebody who is determined to put in effort and hard work, and this person is like trying from the scratch basically. So this person is just starting to bloom basically. You are being crossed by a Capricorn person, or you are being crossed by somebody who is dealing with some addiction, toxic pattern. This person can have a lot of baggage, and this person could be dealing with their issues which are tempting, which are misleading. This could be you as well dealing with the Capricorn person, or you are trying to fight your addiction. You are trying to fight codependency. You are trying to fight something that you know that it is not serving you. So you are trying to move away from it, and this thing is still following you, and it keeps coming up as a challenge over and over again, and you still keep fighting it away because you know that it is not a good habit, or it is not a good person, or it is not a person who deserves your attention. So you are trying to avoid this. Whatever this devil is, you are trying to avoid this. You have to make a decision. So you have to start thinking from your heart space. From your heart space, you have to start thinking, what decision should you make? What decision is in your favor? Is it like, which paths do you take? Is it going to be for you, or is it going to be for other people? Are you trying to make yourself happy, or are you trying to make others happy? So you might be seeking guidance from outside, but actually you will get all the answers from within. So try to calm your mind and close your eyes and ask the right questions. Once you will manage to ask the right questions, the answers will come to you. This is someone in the past that you dealt with, like a earth sign, Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. Somebody who was probably your husband, someone who was a boss, or someone financially very well off, someone who was focused on their money, someone who probably was living in a lot of comfort. This can be your father as well. Somebody who gave you financial support, or this can be you as well. You are going through a heartbreak or a three-party situation. Bottom of the deck, I have three of cups, so that's what I'm saying. On your mind, you feel that there is some three-party going on, and that is why you're feeling hurt in your mind. Basically, your mind is hurting. Thinking about this possible heartbreak, your mind is hurting. You are like, I did not imagine such a thing would ever happen. Now this is you again. I'm also getting Taurus. So this is somebody in your future who is being very, very strict, someone who is not expressing their emotions. This person is really, really hurt, and now they are making all the rational decision, logical decision, not listening to their heart, what they have, what their emotions have to say. They're not even listening to what other people's emotions have to say. So they are pretty focused and unconcerned with emotions or unnecessary details. They just want to they just want the truth, and the truth, that's it. And they want to speak the truth. So if you will ask this person anything, they will cutthroat give you just the truth, and they are very, very professional and very cutting with their words. So I don't know if you are dealing with somebody like this in future or not. For some of you, this is your parent. Like, your parents are telling you like something very in a very concrete or very harsh manner, and it is breaking your heart because you want to, you are very confused about something. Like, you're choosing between two things and you're not able to choose. And this is probably you trying to, stand up on your two feet. And some of you are trying to get liberated from a situation which was holding you back. So it is taking you a lot of effort to make this decision, to move out, to explore your own potential. This is you. You want equal reciprocation. You want to receive love. You want to give love, you want to receive love, you want to have a union where you feel that you are appreciated and loved. Now for this, you will do anything. You are like, I will wait for this. Two of cups. And I'm going to love myself until then. This is somebody loving themselves, trying to fulfill their own desires, their own need for love. This person is going to appreciate themselves. They are going to look into a mirror and offer themselves like a lot of caring words, and this person is going to speak very tenderly to themselves. So this is coming up as you. So probably you are doing all those things to yourself. Some of you are probably going through some therapy, healing work, like self-healing work. Some of you are trying to raise your self-esteem, is what I'm feeling here. somebody around you, like a mother figure or somebody who's giving you a lot of nurturing and support, somebody like a teacher or a therapist, or like somebody who is very loving and caring, like a Taurus person probably, or somebody who is just a very loving energy, they are supporting you, they are around you. And if there is not, like if you can't see this person in physicality, I think there is an energy around you which is supporting your growth. So be mindful of that, that you are being supported by the universe. For some of you, there is a spiritual growth. You are also understanding what is unconditional love. You fear that somebody is going to leave you, or you feel, you want to leave a situation which is not serving you. So you are leaving that situation with a very broken heart. Somebody is also grieving something that happened in the past. So you are probably recalling what has happened in the past, and you want to go back to it. And you really, really miss it, is what I'm getting here. Yes, again this card is coming up. So you really are feeling like, you know, emotionally you are not fulfilled in this situation, and that is why you want to leave the situation for your Two of Cups. You are leaving this Eight of Cups situation for this Two of Cups because you feel that this is what you deserve. Two of Cups is what you deserve. So somebody who is not investing in you emotionally and is not giving you what you are investing in them, you are very much ready to leave the situation which is dark, depressing, and you know, even something that is blocking your view. This is blocking your view, not being able to make a right, correct, informed decision. You want to heal yourself, you want a loving offer. You want to reach out to somebody who is probably an Aquarius or a water sign, and you want to tell them that you like them. Or somebody like a water sign or an Aquarius can come your way with a loving offer. They can offer you, it can be sun, moon, rising. They can tell you that, you know, I am here, you can heal yourself. You can, you know, they can offer you a shoulder to cry, or you are offering somebody healing energy because they have been hurting a lot. So you are recognizing that this person is hurting a lot, and you are offering them support so that they can heal themselves. This can be you as well. You are trying to work on your healing, like I said here, and somebody around you providing space for you to heal. You are dropping all the burden that has been weighing you down. You feel that I was the only one working in this through and through, and this is the point now. I'm going to not go through with this because this is totally not done. You are feeling very exhausted, fatigued. You are feeling tired. You are feeling, you know, you feel that you are chained to somebody or a situation which is never ending. Somebody around you is also trying to give you a solid foundation, like they are trying to invest in your foundation, or you are trying to invest in somebody else's foundation. You want this person to be stable, or this is you trying to bring stability to yourself. Like I said, you are trying to get something stable, and you are working very diligently towards it. So in case you do not have anybody who is supporting you, or a teacher or a guide, I think you should look for somebody like that, and you know, ask for help. Somebody around you can also be, like, I'm not saying this is the same person, but there is somebody around you who is trying to financially you know, control you, or not somebody who says that you do this for me, then I will love you. If you will do this for me, then I will love you. So somebody is giving you conditional love, and you want, what you want is unconditional love. So yes, that is coming up. Some of you are trying to work on your dreams and desires, and you are not going to stop yourself. Like, you know, you are not going to stop until you discover what your true passion is. So you are going to be very, very focused on that true potential or desire, or something related to art as well, or a project that you want to start. Yes, you want to be very clear about the path that you are going to take from now. So whatever path you are going to take from now, you want to be rational about it. You want to be logical about it. You could have been hurt by a Pisces person or a Cancer person, or you are trying to discover something, why I was hurt, how can I heal it. So you are looking for deeper answers and deeper questions you are asking yourself. You are like, how did I end up in this situation? What can I learn from this situation? You're thinking, should I fight some more? Should I keep fighting? And should I should I not give up on this situation? But what I'm getting is that somebody around you is very, very stubborn. It can be you as well. So think about it. If this person is going to think about their way or the highway, are you ready to invest in this person or a situation which is not actually going in your favor? In past, somebody who offered you a lot of care and attention, they offered you a lot of love as well. So it could have been a love at first sight or something. Or this is a very unconditional love that was offered to you in the past. So you are probably thinking about this person as well. Currently, there is a three-party situation. Three-party again. It can be at work. It could be with a Pisces Sun Moon Rising. Somebody who is not communicating anymore, somebody who is holding back information, somebody who is not making any action, somebody who is not reacting or making any moves. So it can be you as well who is going into a enlightenment phase. You will try to look at this entire situation from a bigger picture, like a broader perspective, and you are going to heal yourself is what I'm getting here. So you are trying to heal yourself as well. You are not letting your thoughts and ideas bother you. You are letting it you're letting your thoughts come and go. You're not sticking to anything particular, and you are trying to stay calm in the situation where everything is going haywire, or you feel that as time will pass, things will improve. So that was your reading, Libra. I hope you resonated. In case you did, kindly drop me a comment. I would truly, truly, truly appreciate it. See you again.